Before I start on my next project, I thought I'd just show you what I've done to my room here. This used to be my night shift sleeping quarters. It's air conditioned and soundproofed, so I could go in here and not hear what was going on outside. But I don't work anymore, so that wasn't required, so I've turned it into a little radio workshop. So it used to have a bed in it. I've taken that out and put some of my restored radios there on the left. That's only a few of them, of course. The rest are spread evenly around the home. And I've got my new workstation here. And still around the back, that's the old one that I used to use. You might be used to seeing that one. I've got these are some radios that are waiting to be done. The case of this has already been done, so that's a little record player as well. But these ones in the rack are up next, and I've got a few more out in the garage, so I've got enough to keep me going for a little while. Well, good evening. I've got a healing golden voice here tonight, and just thought I'd have a quick look at it. I picked it up this afternoon. It's apparently been restored at some point, but the guy that sold it to me said it pops occasionally, or crackles or something. So I thought I'd give it a go. It's got a new cord on it, and it's got different screws in it, so someone's had a go at it at some point. The model is a 503E. I haven't looked it up yet. I don't even know what it is. Looks to be from the early 50s maybe. So nice looking radio. The case is good, so yeah, that should be good. I'll just turn it on. We'll just see how it goes, because he has assured me it's working. So I'm going to do the normal thing. I've got an isolation transformer. I've got a variac there, which I've set to about, I'll set it down to about 200 and see what happens. I'll put it on restricted power. And I've got my faulty wattmeter here, which I'll just get a... which I've got a screwdriver, so I can keep resetting it to try and get this silly thing to work properly. I've ordered a new one, so it's a different style of this one. Well, hopefully that'll work, but this one's been a bit ordinary. So let's turn it on. I've got it unrestricted, as I said. This is turned on. I'll give it a bit of volume. It says it's pulling 0.8 watts, I'll bet it's not. Do a reset. And what are we going to get? Yeah, 11. So that's pretty good. So let's see what happens. The new watt meter I've got is actually a display that'll fit in over here somewhere. So should be much better, I hope. We got some noise. Oh, it's actually working. Wow, it's got some crackle in it, alright. So it's only pulling 11.2, so I'm going to go to full power, which is about 200 watts volts at the moment. Wow, hello. So pulling 27 watts, 200 volts. Goodness sake. Yeah, okay. That's got an enormous amount of hum in it. And crackle, I had the volume right down. That hum and noise was coming in with the volume right down. It doesn't mean the crackle isn't the volume control, but certainly the hum is pretty bad. And so any noise that's coming in is after the, or from the volume control onwards, so in the amplifier area somewhere. So I suspect some faulty caps in there. As I said, the gentleman said it was had been serviced, so won't know till we have a look inside. So give me a minute, I shall pull the back off and we'll see what's inside it. So it's got a mix of screws on here, some old slots and some newer Phillips ones. Now, since I've rearranged my workshop here, I don't know where anything is, so I usually have little containers here somewhere to put screws in, but I haven't got them at the moment. I'll have to go and search for them. Oh, that's a, well, that's a PK. It looks pretty good condition, doesn't it? Nice bit of corrosion on the top, but not too bad. Well, there it is. It's come out as one piece. Left the plastic fascia on there, so be careful I don't damage that. All right, there it is. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 valves mixed up here, and the IF and the preamp, and there's your output valve, and that's the rectifier, preamp and detector in there. So it looks pretty good. Two big caps sitting up there. They'll need investigating to see what's going on there. That could be the cause of the hum. Looks pretty clean. Yeah, no, can't see anything wrong there. That one's 24. So 24 and 16 there. Let's have a look underneath. These valves look like they've got some hours on them. What's that? A tone control. Wow, they sure went for cheap, didn't they? All right, so these red caps are usually pretty reliable. They're all over the place, so it looks all right there. So those two electrolytics look like the only ones that's ever been changed. And it's still got a massive amount of hum. You can see that one's been disconnected there, and can't quite imagine which one's which. What's that doing? That's going to ground. That's come for the rectifier. That'll be okay. They don't seem very big caps, do they? Goodness me. That one is the 22. What's that one? 10. So that's 10 and a 22. They're supposed to be 16 and something or other. Forgotten there. So I've managed to find another 6M5 in a radio. So I'm just going to turn this off and I'll swap that tube out. Hot. Hot, hot, hot. Okay. 6V4, that's pretty warm as well. Hang on, there we go. Alright. And power's on. So we're on full power. It's only on about 200 volts, it's not. That's fixed it. Look at that.
Yeah, on your mobile and online.
Fantastic.
ABC Radio Brisbane and Queensland.
Mars Insight Mission
2. Well, that fixed the noise. It's got a mighty hum, though, I got to say. So I'm still going to have to change those caps. There's not a lot of real estate underneath. I'll have to look at other ways of doing that.
Moon landing. There was
so there you go. So that's what it was, a noisy 6M5. I should have belted it while I was doing it, shouldn't I?
Your ABC page on the internet.
Sounds a bit strange.
See what we're doing, because there are lots of
cohesively. You know, I'm sure there were other ways that some people would big classic hit. Fuck me, you.
Doesn't sound the best, I gotta say. Sounds muddy or something. No, that sounds pretty ordinary, so that's gonna need some looking at too. But I'll get rid of those caps first, I think. Just before I change those caps, I thought I'll just check the grid bias on this valve, which may be the cause of the distortion. So there's its pin. One, two, it's pin three is the cathode, and pin 2 there is the grid. So if you can see that, what do we got there? Yeah, 0.6. I spent a bit of time trying to work out where these caps are supposed to go and where they are. If you can see, there's the base of the old capacitors in there, and they've just connected this new capacitor straight. They've just snipped that terminal off and connect it straight on, so that should be right. There's the two resistors there. They're coming off the output from the rectifier, and they're both 6,000 ohms. Where are they? 1420. Yeah, so 6,000 ohms, and there they are. There, there's blue, black, and red. 6,000 ohms, and it comes over to this side, and there's the capacitor coming straight off it. So that's absolutely correct. One thing that is unusual is that one is the original one is a 24 microfarad, yet this C20 here on the diagram is supposed to be 16. So according to the diagram, the two original capacitors are reversed. So I'm going to say that the diagram's wrong, and they've put the wrong, I don't know. Anyway, so I'll just make sure I cover it. I'll just put two 24s in or something. Anyway, well, they've got a 22 in there, so that's actually all right. That's correct. Now the other one, if you can see, that's the output from the rectifier. All they've done is connected a capacitor, which is only 10 microfarad, straight to the ground. So that's not the way this is on the diagram. It comes off the rectifier, okay, but then it's held above ground and goes to the center tap, and that's what this thing is doing here. It's actually mounted, this is the one with the red sleeve on it, it's mounted on a plastic washer or insulating washer system here that's keeping it away from ground. So the outside case, even though when I looked at it originally looked to be earthed, well, it's not. It's above ground. So hence the plastic shield on it. So what the last guy's done is he's cut that line there. So this line is just sitting there. It's not connected to anything. And earthed it on this side. On the negative side of the cap, just goes straight to ground, and this one's just open. So there's no connection to that, to the center tap. So this center tap's going straight up to the grid of the output valve, and it would be offering a negative bias there. And as we checked before, it doesn't have any negative bias, and I suspected that coupling cap may be leaking across and cancelling it out, but that may be the case, but this may also offer a reason for that. So I'm going to reinstate that connection, and I'll up that 10 microfarad cap they've got in there, and I'll make it a 24. We'll see if that fixes the bias issue and the sound issue and maybe the hum issue all in one shot. We'll see what that does. I fitted a new cap in there, so that's 24, I think, microfarad. It's 600 volts, and I've just picked up the old wire that came off the center tap, so it's doing a bit of a circuit. We'll see how it goes. I've kept it close to the chassis to make sure I don't get, well, to minimise any picking up of RF or affecting the RF anyway. Now, the only other thing I could have done was to try and restuff these original caps, but the caps I've got aren't, well, they would have gone in there, but then they're down to 450 volts again, so I think that one's supposed to be 525. Anyway, let's see if that's been successful. All right, so I've got it on restricted, and we're all ready to go. Got power on. It's pulling 11 watts at that stage. Let's go to full power, which is around 200 volts, not quite full power. Well, there it is. I think it's actually going, and there's no hum at all. Well, certainly normal hum. I'll just check that, see if that bias has changed. I sort of don't totally think it will have. I don't know if you can see that, 0.6, no, so it hasn't made any difference to the bias. So I've just connected an antenna to the radio. We'll see what we've got here. Turn it off a bit.
32% off the retail price you've got of you. Coles were available to talk to you this morning. They did send us a statement, though, saying Australians fell in love with Little Shop Minis. Top.
Increasingly is what we have in here in Victoria, and what we've seen incrementally.
Just 135 architecturally designed is nestled between nature reserves with a backdrop of soaring trees and stunning Sheep Station Creek. Closer to nature with clean air and birdsong, yet sight.
Yeah, no, that's working way better, but it's not right. It still sounds muddy and confused. That may be the speaker, but I suspect it's that issue with the bias there on that output tube, so output valve, I should say. All right, I'll investigate that, I guess. It's going to tackle this grid bias problem with the output valve. It gets its bias going through these two resistors to ground. So according to the schematic, it should be 3.1 voltage drop across that resistor, and 1.5 across there, so it should be about 4.6. The two resistors in total add to 60 to 90 ohms, so I should be able to put my meter on there and down to ground, and I should get around about 90 ohms of resistance. When I power it up, I should get 3.5 volts across there and 1.5 volts across there as far as the voltage drop's concerned. So there's the two resistors there, that's the center tap, that one's 60 ohms, and the one underneath you can just see orange, black, that's the 30 ohm. So that's going down to here, which must be ground, I think. So I'll just measure from here, that's the center tap, I should get to earth, I should get 90 ohms. So just go on there and find on earth somewhere, and there we go. And what have we got? 86. Okay, that's pretty close to 90. There might be a bit of a bleed through somewhere else taking some of that out. So I'll turn it on and just see what sort of voltage drops we're getting across these guys. Okay, so there's the center tap, there's the other end of the resistor. We should have 3.1 volts drop, and 3.6, that's right. And from there to ground, should have 1.5 volts. We've got about 2, so that's right. The resistors are doing what they're supposed to do and dropping the voltage, but we're not getting the same voltage drop at the grid. It should be 4 volts, almost minus 4 volts. I think I will change the grid coupling capacitor just to see if that's just leaking through some voltage and cancelling it out. Okay, with that cap replaced, we'll just see if it's made any difference. I'm not terribly confident. So let's see now. That's the grid. And we've got 0.2, so it hasn't made any difference. Okay. So that's out of the equation. So let's just go back. There's the center tap way back at near the rectifier, and we've got six, nearly 7 volts. Probably minus, I just got my probes backwards. Actually, let's reverse it. All right, so here's the center tap at the rectifier, and we've got six, nearly 7 volts negative. So that is 7 volts there above. It goes through a half meg resistor, which is that one there. And it's 1.3. So that is dropping, what, 5 volts or something? That doesn't seem right. I wonder if that resistor's gone up, gone high. I'll just depower, hang on. So I've got my multimeter now on ohms. I'm going on one side of that half meg resistor. Let's see what we get. So up to, it's reading about 0.7 odd meg. Okay, so it's gone up 200,000 ohms. All right, that's done. So we'll see if it makes any difference. So there's the grid. Let's see what's happened. Not a cracker. It's almost made it worse, I think. One thing I should do is just take the speaker out of the equation. So I'll put in the shop speaker and see if that behaves any better. Alright, connected the shop speaker on here, and it's made no difference, so. It sounds terrible. Alright, so that's not the problem, so we've eliminated that. I'm going to turn it off, have some lunch, and have a think. I was going to put the oscilloscope on there just to trace the signal. One thing I hadn't done, and I don't know why I always do it, is divide the radio in two to find out which area's got the issue. So I cut the receiving part of it and check the, well, I check the amplifier. If it's not in the amplifier, then I know it's in the receiving part, and I haven't done that yet. I don't know why. In the meantime, I'd actually change all these caps. There was only about four of them. I don't think there's anything wrong. One had a big crack through it, so I thought, oh, look, just get rid of them, get to take them out of there. So what I can do is I've got a phone, and I'd play music, and I'll just plug it into the volume, where the top of the volume control, and see if it sounds any good from there. If that sounds all right, then we know that the issue's up in the receiving part, so in the RF part of it. So I just got to find the volume. I can't get to that volume control, and I did trace it this morning, and it comes out there. There it is. So I'll just plug that in there. I'll take the antenna off. Actually, I could take that valve out there as well. So I'll just put power on, and I'll dim bulbing it again, just because I have been playing around with it. Now that's fine. So just let me put a song on. Any more of that. That obviously has the problem there. So the problem's in the amplifying section, and I've wasted my time and some caps doing those, because they're all down the RF section. So what can we do? I'll just pull that valve out just for fun. I think it should still work. Yeah.
Okay, so that's the problem. So that RF section is now completely disconnected because I've taken the valve out, and all we've got is the amplifier preamp and the amplifier stage. Okay, let me think about it. Well, I went through that big box I have outside and I found another 6M5. So I'm going to put that in. I've just taken the old one out. Just a matter of getting the pins to line up. There we go. Got our rectifier back. Okay, that's in. And just got to put this 6BA6 back in. Now, if this doesn't work, I'm not sure where we go, because that's I've put all, they're all different valves now to what came in there that they were before, but the 6M5 was a second-hand one. Well, they're both second-hand ones, I suppose. So let's turn it on. I'll just dim bulb it. I didn't actually test that 6M5. It said tested in the little packet that it was in, but it's pretty old looking. So that's playing still. I'll just turn it up. Nailed it. That's it. It was that valve all the time. The valve I put in out of a set that was working. And it's like that. That's amazing. Well, I suppose it's normal. It's perfect. The sound's brilliant. Oh god, nearly lost it. Don't balance radios. There you go. I'll check that and just make sure it's working all right, and I think we're good to go. By curing one, by changing that valve, curing all the racket that it was making by putting another valve in, introduced a second fault. So, okay. All right, great. Well, that'll teach me. I'll go and drag that big box of valves out and catalogue them all and test them and be able to grab them when I need them.
Good morning. It's a beautiful sunny day in Queensland. Winter day. It's a bit cold, but it's going to be 20-odd degrees this morning, or this afternoon. Lovely day. All right, I'm going to do an alignment on this radio here, this healing radio. I've got an AC meter here. And I've got the 455 set up on the generator. I've connected the meter onto the output tube plate via a 0.01 microfarad capacitor. So that's a good place to put it, because you don't have to have the volume screaming to be able to get a measurement, and you don't affect the RF by connecting further down the stream there. So it works quite well. Plus, I can't get to the speaker terminal, the lower terminals behind a couple of valves. It's too hard to get to. So I'll just turn the volume up and we should be able to hear our signal. Okay, it sounds a bit ratty. I think it's the adjustment's out enough that it's getting odd noises through. All right, so we'll just see how we go. I can read that on the meter over there, so start with the one closest to the amplifier stage, see what we get. Much luck there. Seems a bit all over the place, that one. Yeah, there we go. I got a bit out of that one. It cleaned up that the signal too. Okay. Down a bit, getting off the scale here. I think that'll do. I can't, I think that's picked on all those. So. Now the other thing we need to do is check the dial. There's two adjustments here. There's one for the oscillator and one for the antenna. So I'm guessing that's the antenna. All right, so the thing to do now is adjust the dial. Make sure, or check the dial anyway, and make sure it's adjusted correctly. This hasn't got any frequencies written on the dial, so a very nice gentleman sent me a list of radio stations in Australia, and I can use the radio station frequencies as the ones we need. So 600 and 1500 is the normal one that you would use. And I'll just move that away. There's 7ZL from Hobart. That's 600, so just let me center that. That's it there. I've set the meter to 600, so we should be able to pick that up. And there it is. So I'll just do the patter here, and that should adjust that. Alright, so that's set. Now, the next station is in Melbourne, which is 3AK, there it is, around there. And that's 1500. So, I'll centre that. That's pretty good. And adjust my meter. We're looking for 1500, so Not bad. Is it there? No. Really? It's not there. No, it's not that far. Whoa. Okay, so I'll just tune away so I can see which way I'm supposed to go. And I think it's that one. Alright, so I'll just chase it. It's gone further away. Alright, we're nearly there, so I'll just line that up again with 3AK in Melbourne. Okay, good. I'll go back to 7ZL. Let me line that up. There we go. And back here to 600. Come on. There we go. Okay, so I've centered that on 7ZL again. I've got the meter on 600. And we'll just get maximum again. It may have moved slightly. Not sure it has. Oh, yeah. So we're maxed out on that again. And just go back and check the other end, of course. Just keep doing that until we get them both right. And middle of 3AK again. Put the meter up to 15. And that's right in the middle, so we're leaving it there. Now the other adjustment is the antenna, so just adjust that for the best or highest signal. Okay, there you go. So that should be all right. I'll just check. We're still on about 15. Close enough. And that's right in the middle of 3AK, so that's good. Let's go back to 7ZL and put that on 600. And we should be on the spot. There we go. Terrific. Okay, that's all done then. So I'll put the antenna back on. I'll just see how we go. If I adjust that, I'll put it on center 4KQ. Turn it up. So that's pretty good. QR doesn't line up anymore because they move the frequency.
The whole of the community.
It's about where it should be. QG should be okay.
The situation in Xinjiang province with the Muslim Uyghur population in the wake of...
So, yeah, that's good. That's perfect. Next, we'll just zip over to 4BC. We'll see. I don't even know if we'll get 4BC. It's hard to get that one.
Buried under the moon's largest crater.
Yep, spot on. So the dial's perfect. All right. Well, good morning again. I'm still having trouble with this old healing golden voice. I ran it yesterday for quite a while, and it started to break down, and the volume would go up and down. I took some measurements. The B plus was varying by some 50-odd volts. So I pulled that 6M5 valve out, which I had tested written on the packet, but when I tested it, it was short. So it had shorts all the way through it. So you're allowed one short. I think it had about four different selections would come up short. So I've ended up with about 5 6M5s, and they all test exactly the same. Well, not actually, some are worse than others. But I haven't got a good 6M5 now. So out of five of them, none of them work. So what I'm going to do is just replace it temporarily with a 6BM8. It's a pentode with a triode in it as well, but we just use the pentode section. So there's our 6M5 pentode, and we're just going to use this part of this 6BM8 and just test it out. I can't find any 6M5s for sale on the internet. I've just emailed the club to see if they've got any. So this morning what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this Novell base connected to the existing leads of this valve here, the 6M5 valve base, and I will just put the fly leads over to the correct positions because the pinout on the two valves is different. So I don't want to change all these wires around in here and then find that it makes no difference. So this is just temporary to see if it's going to fix it. Well, this is going to take a while to do, so I'll just turn the cameras off, do this, and I'll come back. Well, there it is. I've wired the new socket into the existing socket, and I think I've got it all right. It was pretty easy, so we're going to go give it a go, I suppose. I've got an antenna on, so we should get some sort of noise out of it. So I've got it on restricted power at the moment, and I'll just flick it on. I'll just reset my wattmeter, and we've got 14.9 watts. So there's no smoke coming out. That's good. Tin bulb's working all right. So let's see if anything happens.
Very
important job.
Yeah.
Yes. I've got a lot of questions. Did you get $2,000?
Lovely pun.
Nice.
Oh, nice work. Still doesn't sound flash.
Let's see if you can win the.
All right, Katrina sounds pretty good there. One thing this never had was the bias, and it may well have been because the valves were shorted out and just dragging it down. So I'm going to see if I can measure the bias. So the bias is now reading 1.2 or something. Yeah. So it's still not flush. This thing needs about 15 volts, minus 15. It still doesn't sound very good because the bias is way out. So I've connected my phone again just to the amplifier stage, and it still doesn't sound right, and the volume's going up and down. So yeah, so it's still got an issue there in the amplifier stage. So I'm going to have to sit here and nut this out a bit. Try and work out what's going on. I've been looking at this schematic, and this little cap here, there's actually a tone switch there, and all it does is switch this cap in and out, or this connects it to the plate via a cap. Now I initially suspected this capacitor, this coupling capacitor, as being bad and changed it and thought the DC was coming across here, raising its voltage because I can't get a negative bias. Now the same thing's going to apply if this cap's leaking and it leaks some high voltage across there into the grid and cancels out our negative bias. So interestingly, this one, that's the tone switch, and all it does is connect that or disconnect it. So a way to testing that, of course, is just to flip the tone switch across and see what happens. And that's what I've done, so I'll show you what happens. The radio is running, and there we've got minus 6 volts, 6.5 volts, which is exactly what it should be. Now if I put the tone switch to, there it goes, look. Well, it's actually, no, sorry, I've put the tone switch to low. So I've actually connected that cap into the circuit. So I flick it out again, and we've got our 906. So there's the capacitor there, that's a mica, and it's going from the plate here through the switch, and then it goes back to the grid. That pin there is just it's not connected to the valve, so they're just using it as a junction, but that's going off to the grid. So I am going to change that cap there, and that'll fix everything, I'm sure. There's the varmint there. It's supposed to be 200 picofarads. And I'm measuring it there. It's coming up at 236, so it's out of tolerance. I can't measure it with a voltage behind it, so this is the fact that it's gone out of tolerance would indicate there's a problem with it there. All right, so we've powered it up again with the new capacitor in there. Okay, so in now the bias is back to 6. So just put a bit of Adam Lambert on there. Okay, can't put too much on. How about a bit of Scylla? Fantastic. So that's working perfectly now. We've got our negative bias back, which is what I was searching for 2 days ago. And I'm ashamed that I took so long to twig to that. All right. Well, I guess that's going. I've sent the club, one of the radio clubs, the Australian, well, the more national one anyway, radio club an email asking if they've got the 6M5. They're showing they've got 4 brand new ones. I'll see if one of them shows up. I don't think I'll go through with actually fitting this valve permanently because I've got to get the change the bias. So I'll see if I can get a 6M5. If I can't, I'll have to retrofit this particular valve, which is a 6BM8. There is another valve that's a bit more interchangeable with the 6M5. It's got different wiring, but it's got a similar bias, so I don't have to worry about that. I haven't got any of those. I've got 21 of these or something, or 30 something. These ones, and I haven't got any of the other. I can't remember what the number of the other one was. So I'll see how it all pans out. If I can get the 6M5, I'll put them in. Otherwise, I'll have to. Maybe I can get the other valve, the other type, and then just rewire the sockets there, and I don't have to do anything else.
Lighting Illusions end of financial year clearance is on now.
The old golden voice is back. It sounds terrific now. So, yeah, live and learn.
Just a bit of an update. This radio was working quite well. I ran it for a couple of hours this morning, and it was fine. Didn't play up at all. But then all of a sudden, it started to get the odd crackle in it, and within minutes, it had gone to just totally broken down and just crackle. You couldn't hear anything else. So I knew immediately this would be the guy. This C15. It's a mica. I think it's a 200 puff mica. So I should have changed that when I changed this one because it's got the same voltage on the top of it, and I should have just changed it. I didn't see any playing up, so I didn't worry about it. There's some other caps on the B plus that are going to ground, another one there, but they're 0.05 microfarad, and I've already changed them. So I've changed this guy here, and there he is, a new one. Here's the old one, same as the one we had yesterday, and I'll just give it a test, and it'll be high. Yeah, there it is, 223, it's supposed to be 200. If it was in good condition, I would expect that to come up close to 200, not 223. So that little extra, the 23 puff showing there is significant, I think, in letting us know what these caps are doing. So that's my theory. Well, there it is, a healing golden voice from 1953. It's a model 503E, and I now realize those mica capacitors, when they've got a bit of voltage on one side, will fail. They're they're pretty reliable normally, but when it's under a bit of pressure, they are failing. People that know what they're doing would have been looking at it going, check that cap, when you haven't got your grid bias. And I couldn't find the grid bias for a 6M5 anyway. I looked everywhere. I ended up, found it on under an EL80, I think, which is the equivalent, and it was -7. So that was the first time I'd seen anything. That's why I sort of abandoned it, because I couldn't work out what I was supposed to be searching for. Anyway, it's all working now, and it's working quite well. Sounds good. I'll put it on the rack with the rest of them. Well, that's it for today. So I'm going to go outside in the sun and enjoy the day. If you can subscribe, that'd be fantastic. Any comments are always welcome, positive or negative. I don't mind. I'm happy to learn off people's experience. We'll see you next time. We have a bit more fun with the radio.